morning children, welcome for today's lecture. Today we are going to start with the grammar portion. Lesson number 1, first lesson is parts of speech and homonyms in your lesson. Understood? So what is parts of speech? The definition you must come to know, and what are the name the parts of speech? We will go on with the portions bit by bit after this main explanation is over. So what is parts of speech and homonyms? Here, words are divided into different kinds of classes called parts of speech according to the work they do in a sentence. And remember, see, definition, whenever you go through any sentence, subject in this, first you should come to know the definition. If you go through the definition and understand the definition, then it will be easy for you to understand. Understood? And remember, this is not only for 7th standard, this is applicable for higher classes also. This is grammar, your base must be strong. So always remember that, try to understand each and every definition and the explanation done. Okay, so here, parts of speech, words are divided into different kinds of classes called parts of speech. So words, they are divided how? Into different kinds of classes, different groups of classes, and that is known as parts of speech. How? According to the work done in a sentence. So words, division into group of different kinds of classes, and that division is known as parts of speech. And they have, how they decided? According to the work done in a sentence. Easy parts of, what is parts of speech? Parts of speech, always you have heard. What it is, you don't know. They are words divided into different kinds of classes, and depends upon the work done in the sentence. That is parts of speech. See, how many parts of speech are there? 8. What are they? Noun, adjective, adverb, verb, pronoun, preposition, conjunction, interjection. Again, I'm repeating. Noun, adjective, adverb, verb, pronoun, preposition, conjunction, interjection. Once again I am repeating. Noun, adjective, adverb, verb, pronoun, preposition, conjunction, interjection. These are the 8 parts of speech. Parts of speech definition, what it is? Divided into different kinds of class called parts of speech, and it depends upon the work done. 8 parts of speech are there: noun, adjective, adverb, verb, pronoun, preposition, interjection, conjunction. Now each one of them we will explain. What is a noun? A noun means, see, in the previous lesson in the textbook we came to know, pick out the common noun and proper noun. Common noun means the name of a person, place, animal or thing. For example, girl, book, ball, all those things. Adjective means describing a noun or a pronoun, and that gives meanings. For example, Sita is an intelligent girl. Sita is now, how, what type of girl she is? She is an intelligent, so intelligent adjective. Adverb means that tells more about a verb. L-Y, L-Y, slow, slowly, costly. Then luckily. Then verb, doing any kind of action. See, the boys are running. Running means doing kind of verb. That is verb. Pronoun, use instead of noun. For example, Sita is a studious girl. She studies in 10th standard. Again, I didn't use Sita. What I told, Sita is a studious girl, and she, instead of again using Sita, I use she. So that is instead of noun. Preposition means it shows place, time, position. That is preposition. Under the table, under the bridge, on the table, inside the book. Conjunction means joining of, linking of two words. It is raining heavily, so I took the umbrella. Raining heavily, so connection between two sentences. Interjection means expression. Wow, hooray, alas. All those is interjection. So understood parts of speech, what it is? Kinds of classes, divided into different kinds of classes, and they work according to the depends upon the work they do. 8 parts of speech are there. Then noun, adjective, adverb, verb, pronoun, preposition, conjunction, interjection. So what is a noun? That which presents place, animal, person, place or thing. Then adjective, describing a noun. That which adds meaning. Adverb means, what is an adverb? Tells about a verb. Then verb means doing any kind of action. That may be running, eating, sleeping, jumping, whatever it is. Pronoun means is used instead of a noun. I have told you pronoun, name of a person. Sita is a studious girl. She studies in standard 10. Sita is a studious. Sita, pronoun. And instead of proper noun. And instead of using again Sita, what I use? She. I, she, they, all those pronouns. Preposition means the relation, shows the relation between word and pronoun. Conjunction, joining of two, linking of two sentences. And interjection means expressing feeling. Wow, hooray, etc. And what is homonym? Homonym means a word that is which is used in one part of speech can be used in another part of speech or another sentence. For example, the same word can be used as a noun and an adjective, a noun and a verb, adverb and preposition. The meaning may be different. Such words are spelt and pronounced in the same way but have different meanings and are used in different parts of speech are called homonyms. So what is homonym? Pronounces same having different meanings. Understood? Having different meanings. So what it is today? You see, I got a free ticket to water park. Kumar tried to free that. Free. Oh, say word is same, but meaning is different. That is homonym. The same way example what it is. The rich should help the poor. The poor woman had to beg for noun adjective. Poor used in different form, but the pronounces way of telling is the same. So understood? This is see. So in your grammar book, page number 6, you'll have to do it in your grammar book. Understood? The answers depending upon the explanation. So again here parts of speech divided into different kinds of classes or parts of speech according to the work they do in a sentence. 8 parts of speech are there: noun, adjective, adverb, verb, pronoun, preposition, conjunction, interjection. Noun means name of person, place, animal, thing. Adjective giving meaning to noun. Adverb, what is an adverb giving? This adverb tells more about a verb. Verb doing any kind of action. Pronoun means used instead of a noun. Preposition shows the relation between word, noun and pronoun. Conjunction, linking of two sentences. Interjection, expression of emotions and feeling. Wow, hooray, etc. So I hope you might have understood this lecture. After explanation of this, then only I will move to the next lesson. Read the lesson and make that all the definitions must be learned by. Okay, so we'll meet you in the next lecture. Till then, take care. Thank you.